Welcome back to the Rhode Show. This morning in the buzz, yes, the kids are back in school, but the days of heavy backpacks and loads of notebooks and pencils may soon be a thing of the past. In growing numbers, Rhode Island schools are moving away from the traditional school supplies and moving into the world of the cloud. Coventry recently purchased nearly 3,000 Chromebooks, a Google-based laptop for students in grades 6 through 12. Cumberland, West Warwick have also bought Chromebooks for students. First of all, I'm a tech guy. I love the technology. I think it is a great idea. I know a lot of people love the idea of having the books, and I understand that because, you know, you can write in the books, you can flip the pages, but to see the kids, first of all, carrying the heavy backpacks that we've all carried is tough. Not to make babies out of any of the kids, you know, it just is a thing. But technology's not going anyplace. Mm-hmm. These kids have to learn how to use technology. They have to be able to reference technology and be able to pull information in. I think you need stuff like this in the school. Maybe it's not the primary thing you use every day, but I think every kid, we've got enough money to send it to every place else in the world. We need to start taking care of these kids here in the country and supplying them with the technology that they need, because it's not going away.
I do appreciate that, because I even feel as though now, going to even college with different kids from different states, they grew up even just simple, something as simple as a typing class, so they didn't have to look at the keyboard or do, you know, they were just introduced to more technology. And so when you got to that point when you were typing a paper, even, like I said, even something as simple as taking typing. I wish they offered typing when I was in school. But I'm old school.
Because you need it.
We do need it now, right, and you need it for work and for the for life in general, because you're right, it's not going anywhere. So I think incorporating some technology classes is nice, but I'm very old school with stuff. I like writing things down. I still write things in a planner. That little app on my phone, never used it, never touched it, never written a note in my phone. I'd rather write a note on a post-it and put it somewhere. So I don't know, I think there's something to be said about finding the balance between both, because kids are consumed by so much technology. They're looking at screens all the time.
Right.
So I think sometimes it's nice to give them a break and say, here's a physical book, flip through it, figure it out.
I heard one teacher say, after the stuff came in to the classroom, that the kids actually know how to use the technology more than some of the teachers do, because the kids are on it all the time. They grew up with all of this technology in their everyday life.
First time I learned Angry Birds was from four-year-olds.
There you go.
I kid you not.
There it is.
Brendan, technology, yay or nay? Are you old school? Do you write things down, or do you type it out?
First of all, I was the four-year-old that taught you how to play Angry Birds. I think we should get that out there. But no, you have to embrace technology, although I still do write down a lot of things, but then I end up losing the paper. So it's just this horrible spiral.
Vicious cycle.
I'm trying, though. But you have to embrace it. Most importantly, here's what our social media friends are saying about this topic this morning. Patricia Adelio was Estrella kicks things off with her thoughts. On the positive side, knowledge is at your fingertips. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. The negative is when you see a teenager who can't make change.
That's true.
Yeah.
It's true.
You need those basic skill sets as well.
Definitely. Alexandra Lexi Chris adds, my concern is that just because we have more access to information doesn't mean that we have more understanding. I also hope students will still take the time to make flashcards by hand and write down notes. Mm-hmm. How I used to love opening up a new pack of pens or pencils.
Oh, yeah.
Confession, I still do.
The Yikes pencils, I loved that brand.
Those were classic. And lastly, Cree Lynn says, I remember having lots of busy work for homework in elementary school. There's nothing worse than pointless word searches for homework. I